बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट। टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ आवर डिस्कशन इज़ द सिमेट्री। इट इज़ द एक्चुअली द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द लास्ट लेक्चर। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द सिमेट्री एंड द सिमेट्री थिंग्स दैट इज फाउंड इन द नेचर। वी नो दैट द सिमेट्री एलिमेंट इज अ ज्योमेट्रिकल एंटिटी सच एज लाइन, plane are a point about which one can perform an operation of rotation, reflection or inversion, etc. We have also learned about the identity. We know that symmetry have of two basic categories, which one was the translational symmetry and the second one was the point symmetry. Translational symmetry was the actually the movement of an object in space by a certain distance in a certain specific direction, while the point symmetry on the other hand occurs in molecules where there is at least one point in space that remains unchanged with respect to any symmetry operation. We have already discussed the objectives and the identity also. The identity was actually the doing nothing to a molecule. The second symmetry operation is the proper rotation, which is represented by Cn. Second type of point symmetry operation is actually the proper rotation. A proper rotation is a symmetry operation that occurs around a line known as proper rotation axis in order to bring the object into an equivalent configuration. For example, a snowflake has a six-fold proper rotational axis that runs perpendicular to the plane. Here we can see that it is actually has a six-fold proper rotation axis that runs perpendicular to the plane of the snowflake that passes directly through its center. Proper rotation is abbreviated by the symbol Cn, where n is equal to the rotation around the axis by 2 pi over n radians. We know that the total radiation angle is 360, so 360 over n. For example, the benzene molecule has a C6 proper rotation axis. Here is the benzene ring that possesses a benzene ring possesses directly through the donut hole in its center as shown in figure A. Rotation of a molecule by 60 degree moves each carbon atom into its neighbor's original position. Notice that the principal axis does not necessarily need to pass through an atom. The C6 rotational axis can also serve as a C3 axis. This is the same axis as rotation by 120. Also lead to an equivalent configuration. So there is a quite different between the C3 and the C6. Although both rotations are from same axis of rotation, but if we rotate C6 rotation axis, then we need to move the molecule or rotate the molecule by 60 degree moves each atom into its neighbor's position. So notice that the principal axis does not necessarily need to pass through an atom. The C6 rotational axis can also serve as C3 axis, but by the rotation 120, it is also lead an equivalent configuration. We say that C3 rotational axis is collinear with the C6 operations on the molecule. This is quite important thing. In benzene molecule, there is also a C2 rotational axis that is collinear with the aforementioned C6 and C3 axis that corresponds with rotation of the molecule by 180. So it is quite obvious from the above said things that if we rotate benzene molecule with C6 rotation, we need to actually rotate it by 60 degree. And if we need to rotate, if we need to give the C3 rotation of this by the same principal axis or the axis of rotation, we need to actually rotate 120 degree. It means we actually rotate 180 degree. This example serves so to illustrate one of the fundamental properties of symmetry operation that can be multiplied together in much same manner as the set of real number can be multiplied, with the exception that symmetry operation of molecule do not necessarily communicate and therefore the order of multiplication matters. The two C6 rotation performed in succession are identical to one C3 rotation about the same axis. Similarly, three C6 rotations are equivalent to one C2 rotation. This is quite easy to understand what we are going to try, what we are going to sing, and what we are going to convey the message. The two C2 rotations performed in succession are identical to one C3 rotation about same axis. Similarly, three C6 rotations are equivalent to one C2 rotation. The symmetry operation are said to multiply together as shown in equation, this one, the first equation and the second equation. By the conversion, the last operation in the product is the one that is always performed first. There are also an additional six C2 proper rotation axes in the benzene ring. Here we can see that there are the extra C2 rotation in benzene. If one were to look at benzene from an edge on vantage point and look directly down to the line that consent one of the carbon atom with the imaginary center of molecule and with the carbon atom directly opposite the first one, the entire benzene ring could be rotated by 180 degree. This is the equivalent configuration that we get after the performing C2 rotation. Thus, there are three C2 dash rotation axes that are each perpendicular to the C6 axis of the molecule. So there are three C2 in diagram B, we can see that there are three C2 dash rotations that are occur perpendicular to the principal axis C6. So there are two type of axes that exist between the molecules if they have more than one type of rotations, the axis of rotation and the principal axis of the rotation. We will discuss the this term later. Thus, there are three C2 dash rotation axes that are each perpendicular to the C6 axis of the molecule, which each contain two of the C6 carbon atoms as shown in the figure B. There are also C2 dash here in we can see that in picture C, a rotation axis that also lie in the plane of molecule but bisects the carbon-carbon bond. This C2 dash was bisects the atom of carbon. This is the actually bisects the bond between the atoms. So this is the C2. There are also C2 double dash rotation axis that also lie in the plane of the molecule, but it bisects the carbon-carbon bonds. Here we can see in the picture C. The rotational axis with the largest value of N is called the principal axis of rotation. So there are two types of rotation exist, the principal axis of rotation and the axis of rotation. So the principal axis of rotation is actually the rotational axis with the largest value of N. In this case, the principal axis is the C6 rotational axis because This is the largest value of n in rotational axis. Benzene possesses C6, C3 as well as C2, many types of C2, but the principal axis would be the C6. Some molecule with higher symmetry, for example tetrahedral molecules, may actually contain more than one principal axis. By convention, the Z coordinate axis is always taken as principal axis. This is quite complex type of symmetry operations that we may not need at this time. The direction of rotation around the principal axis is arbitrary. Some textbooks also prefer to use clockwise rotations, where others define the rotation in the counterclockwise directions. This is actually choice is entirely up to you. What would you like? You would like to rotate the molecules clockwise or the anti-clockwise. Here we can see that the C more about the proper rotation. The symmetry element is the line counterclockwise rotation is taken as positive. Principal axis is actually the axis with the largest n value. I have already told you about this. So this table is quite helpful to understand the rotation operation, symmetry operation. For example, if we need to perform C6 operation to any molecule, there would be about 60 degree change of the structure. So if we talk about the C3, the rotation angle should be the 120, while in case of C2 or C6-3, it means we are performing C6 three times. So if we perform C6 three times or directly C2, the rotation angle would be the 180 degree. So in case of C3 two times, if we perform C3 two times, there is a difference between the subscript and the superscript. We should be aware of the difference between the subscript and the superscript. In the subscript, this is the rotation, and while the superscript is the number of times that we are going to rotate, that we are going to perform an operation to any molecule. So C2 means 180 degree rotations, while C2-3 is actually C6-3 is actually C6 three times is also equal to 180. So C3 twice means we need to provide 240 rotation angle to any molecule, while this is the same with the if we perform C6 four times. C6 five times is equal to the 300 rotation angle, while identity is actually the full rotation or doing nothing at all with the molecule. Here we can see there are examples of the some rotation operations. We can see here this is the C3 exist between the molecule. This is also C3. Here we can see that this is actually the cross section of protein disc of tobacco mosaic virus. We can perform, there are the 17 faces of the this protein disc of the specific virus. So we need to perform C17 axis of rotation. For this, how much we need to rotate? We can simply divide 360 over 17. The result would be the rotation of the C17 axis. So here are the different other examples of the rotation. We can see there are six faces of this molecule. This is actually the snowflake design. If we rotate, we can perform C6 as well as C3 and C2 also. So there are multiple rotation operations are possible in the snowflake designs. So what would be the principal axis and the axis of rotation? So there would be the C6 is the actually the principal axis, because it has the largest possible n values, while C2 and C3 would not be considered the principal axis. Here is the other example to understand the proper rotation. So what kind of operations are generated by C5 axis? This is the example, we can say this is the cyclopentane. For our understanding, we marked carbon 1 as the number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 as well. So if we perform C5 rotation, C5 means 360 over 5. If we rotate the C5, the one atom shift its position from here to at 2 position, and subsequently 2 at 3, while the all other atoms change their position subsequently. So actually, if we just remove the numbers, we can remove the number from the parent molecule and the changed or operationed molecule, we can say that there is no difference. These are seems to be identical, but actually they are not identical. So they are indistinguishable from their original shape. So there is operation if there is any indistinguishability between the molecule. We can perform another C5 operation to this molecule and get this type of configuration. And moreover, we can also perform again C5, again C5. So if we perform, this is actually one C5, this is a second time C5. We can also perform this operation directly from parent to this one. So we can write C5 twice. C5, it means we have performed C5 two times. Here C5 three times we have performed, C5 four times we have performed, and we get this kind of indistinguishable shape. So what happened if we go one stage further, that is the C55. If we perform C55 to this is the molecule that was at the start point. Actually this is the identity. So here is the one example or the problem that we need to solve if we understand the concept of the proper rotation. Identify all the proper rotational axes in square planar PTCL 4 2 minus, and indicate which is the principal axis. Then show that the following multiplication of symmetry operation are valid. Which one? C4, C4 is equal to C4 two times is equal to C2, and C4 four times is equal to identity. Yes, could you think you can perform this? If yes, that's very, very good. If no, we need to learn how to solve this issue. Here we can see that this is the structure of PTCL4. This is the square planar structure, and here we can see that for our easiness, I have written the I have marked the chlorine with A, B, C and D. So there are two type of clear rotations found. This is actually the principal axis from the platinum towards the observer. We can rotate this molecule and perform C4 as well as C2 rotation in the same axis. It is drawn in red color. So what happened if we perform C2 and C4 rotation, and even there are many C2 others like C2 dash and C2 double dash type of rotations. So if we perform the C4 rotation in this molecule, we can set this, the chlorine A change its position and change and occupy the position of B, and same B occupy the position of C, C occupies the position of D, and D will occupy the position of A. This is actually the C4 rotation. C4 rotation means 360 over 4 is equal to C4, C4 rotation. So if we perform the C2 rotation exactly on the same axis of rotation, so the A would occupy the position of C, and C would occupy the position of A, and B occupy the position of D, and D definitely the position of B. So this is the C2 rotation in square planar PTCL4. So if we talk about the another C2, which is between the atoms, if we intersect the atoms, we can find there is a axis of rotation named C2 dash, because this is another one C2, so we for easiness we marked it C2 dash. So this is C2 dash and C2 double dash intersects. This is the actually the intersection of the atoms, the bonds. So C2 double dash. So there is a C4 rotation. Here we can see that the actually the change in position of the atoms and the C2 and C2 dash and the C4. So the what would be the principal axis? We know that principal axis is actually that axis which have the largest value of n. So the largest value of n possess C4. So the answer is the principal axis is one with the largest value of n, which is the case in the C4. So after the second symmetry element, which was the axis of rotation operation, now we are going to talk about the third symmetry element, which is the reflection and represented by sigma. The third point symmetry operation is known as reflection, which occurs when an equivalent configuration results in an object is reflected an equal distance through a mirror plane. The reflection operation is given the symbol sigma. This is the sigma. The benzene molecule, for example, has a rather obvious mirror plane that lies in the plane of molecule itself and is perpendicular to the principal axis, as in figure A. We can see that this is actually the perpendicular to the principal axis. The principal axis of the benzene was the C6 rotation, and the C6 rotation was performed from this position towards the observer. If we draw a line from this point towards the and towards the observer, we got a principal axis rotation, which is the C6. And this actually, the benzene molecule, this actually has a rather obvious mirror plane that lies in the plane of the molecule itself and is perpendicular to the principal axis. Here we can see in the picture A. Benzene also exhibits a set of mirror planes that contains a principal axis and pass two of the carbon atoms are sometimes more in sigma H, while the two carbon atoms in others, while simultaneously containing one of the three C2 dash axis as shown in B. We know that here are the same C2 dash proper rotation exist in the benzene, and which is actually the between the atoms, while C2 double dash was the between the atoms. Here we can see that this is actually the sigma passes from between the atoms and between the bonds. This is the between the bonds. So we can see, while simultaneously containing one of the three C2 axes as in B, finally there exist three more mirror planes in molecules that contain the principal axis, bisects the carbon-carbon bond that contain one of the C2 double dash axes, which is shown in the figure C. Whenever there is more than one plane in a molecule, the mirror planes are divided into classes on the basis of geometrical considerations and given subscripts in order to distinguish between them. So we need to describe the different types of sigma present in a molecule, whether it may be the sigma H, V and D. We need to write subscripts in the sigma. A horizontal mirror plane known as sigma H is always perpendicular to the principal axis. So sigma H is actually the plane which is perpendicular to the principal axis, and it is denoted by with sigma h. Therefore, there can only be one horizontal plane in any given molecule. The mirror plane shown in A, this is the diagram A, is always perpendicular to the principal axis. The mirror plane is actually in figure A is a horizontal mirror plane. Vertical mirror planes sigma v for vertical, on the other hand, always contain the principal axis. In the case of molecules such as benzene, where there are two different types of vertical mirror plane, a further distinction between the classes is required. The mirror plane in B that passes through the carbon atoms and contains as many atoms as possible are designated as sigma V vertical. Whereas the mirror plane in C that bisects the carbon-carbon bonds are known as dihedral mirror planes and are given the symbol sigma D. A dihedral mirror plane is simply a subset of vertical mirror plane. A more rigorous definition is actually of the difference between the vertical and dihedral mirror plane is that a vertical mirror plane will contain more atoms than dihedral one. Or if they contain the same number of atoms, a vertical mirror plane will contain one of the three Cartesian axes, which is the x, y or the z axis. So here we can see that this is the simple restriction on the planes of symmetry, which is rather obvious but can sometimes be helpful in finding plane. A plane must either pass through an atom or else that type of atom must occur in pairs symmetrically either side of the plane. This is very important to learn about the sigma or the plane of symmetry. Here we can see there are different examples of sigmas. From there we can see the plane of symmetry is also present in human beings as well as the objects. Here we can see that this is actually the cut. We can cut the two things into equal halves. So it means there is actually reflection or the mirror image present between the molecules and between living organisms. This is the example of different molecules. Here we can see that we can cut this molecule into two equal halves, or this is actually the mirror image of both. So this is the example of water molecule and ammonia, NH3. We can see that there are two type of mirror image present in water molecule and three types of mirror image or sigma present in the NH3. So the next one is the inversion. The fourth point symmetry operation is inversion. The inversion operation given the symbol I takes every point x, y or z and convert into an equivalent configuration at point minus x, minus y and minus z. Thus, there can only be one inversion center and it can only occur in exact center of molecule. The inversion center in benzene is shown by an imaginary black point that lies in the center of molecule as shown in figure. Here we can see that this is actually the example. Notice that the inversion center need not contain an atom because labels A to F, here we can see that on the carbon atoms are imaginary. Inversion still brings the molecule into a configuration that is equivalent to original. We can see different examples over there to learn about the inversion center. this generates the, actually the inversion center generates the operation of inversion through the center. Draw a line from any point. For example, if I talk about this molecule, so here we can see that if we draw a line from any point to the center of the molecule, actually this is the center of the molecule, and we are going to draw a line and produce it an equal distance to the other side. So if it comes to an equivalent point, the operation of inversion is a symmetry operation. For example, this is the ethane in staggered conformation. We can see that we need to draw a line from any point. This is actually the central point of the staggered ethane molecule and produced an equal distance to the other side. We need to move and this side, and if we move to the opposite side of the same distance, if we find the same atom or molecule on the other side of the center, then it means that molecule possess the inversion center, otherwise not. So there are different molecules which have inversion center. For example, this is again the example of ethene, and this molecule do not possess the inversion center, because if we draw a line from this center to this side, H4 side, there is an atom of hydrogen. So on the other side, we need to travel the same distance on the opposite direction. So this is actually the opposite direction. So we do not find any kind of hydrogen atoms over there. So it means there is no inversion center in this molecule. So a symmetry element is actually, this is a point, sometimes difficult to see, sometimes not present when you think you see it. Ethene has identity, and this is actually the methane, which does not possesses identity operation. Tetrahedron, triangles, pentagons do not possesses inversion center, while the square planars, parallelograms, rectangle solids, octahedra possesses the inversion operation. Here we can see that actually if you draw a line, if you draw a dot in the middle of the molecule, and you need to travel in one any direction like this, I would like to travel on this side. Here we can see that after getting the same molecule or atom on one side, we need to travel opposite side of the same point here. So if we find the same atom, it means it possesses inversion center, otherwise not. Here we can see that this is actually triangle, this is the center point, I need to travel this side. Here I find an atom, while on the other side I need to travel the same distance, but I didn't find the same atom. It means this molecule do not possess inversion center. And this is the very classical and easy example to understand about the inversion center, whether it have or not. This is actually the black point, and we need to travel on the side D. We have find an atom, actually this is the carbon, and we need to travel on the opposite side A. This is actually the carbon atoms. So there is an inversion center in the benzene molecule. And this was all about the inversion center. I hope you got the point, and thank you very much.